So science has its value in terms of utility, but science cannot open up the existence for human experience. It will not, it can never do it because they are going with intellect. Intellect as an instrument works only to dissect. The only way intellect can approach anything is to break it up and see. If you ask a scientist to find out something about this flower, first thing is he will break it up into pieces. I think I should ask a scientist to make me understand one of you. He will talk about dissecting you then. If you break this up, you may know many parts of this. You may know the structure of it. You may know the chemistry of it. But you will not know the beauty of it. You will not know the completeness of it, because flower is an expression of a plant finding its fulfillment. It is the highest thing for the plant. For its life, this is the highest happening. It's the flowering of that life. You will not know that. You will not see the hand of the Creator in this if you break it up. But as a whole, if you are willing to pay attention, absolute attention, if in your approach you make this flower more important than yourself and keep your focus on it, you will see the whole universe in this. If you break it up, you will have petals, you will have other parts of the flower, and you will come to vulgar conclusions, and then you will learn how to make use of it. So right now, unfortunately, our approach, what we call as science, has become like this: how to use everything in the universe for our benefit. If you see a tree, in America they call it wood. I was this happened when I when I was in college. This happened about 4 years ago when I was in Mysore. For the first time I conducted a program after many, many years. And all kinds of people turned up, my teachers from school and college turned up. They wanted to see. What has happened to me? So after I spoke there and we had 2 day event and then my English teacher came and hugged me and she said, "Now I know why you wouldn't let me teach Robert Frost." I said, "Why, ma'am, why would I not let you teach Robert Frost? I like Frost." She said, "No, do you remember you wouldn't let me teach Frost?" Then I remembered. One day she came and she opened the book and she introduced Robert Frost as a glorious poet, and then she started off, "Woods are lovely, dark and deep." I said, "Stop." I said, "A man who calls a tree a wood, I don't want to listen to him." She said, "No, no, Robert Frost is a great poet." I said, "I don't care how great he is. A man who calls a tree a wood, I will not listen to him." I didn't let her teach. I didn't let her teach Frost. So after many years she comes up to me and she says, "Now I know why you wouldn't let." So if a tiger comes here now, from the mountains I mean, if you come from Sri Lanka, that's different. If a tiger comes down from the mountain, looks at you, he will think, "Wow, dinner." So you look at a tree and you think, "Wood." It's all right for a tiger to do that, because that's all he knows. But it's not all right for you to do that, isn't it? But right now, that is all science has become. Anything we see, how to make use of it. Anything we see, how to make use of it. Even an invisible atom, we won't leave. Even the goddamn boson Already people are talking about in how many ways it could be used. We could make a boson bomb. You understand? If we make a boson bomb, all of you will just vanish. We don't even have to deal with your dead bodies. Yes, because you'll cease to exist just like the boson. Instead of shooting you dead or burning you to death, if we make all the protons in your body collide with each other, you'll just vanish. You want the technology? But they will tell you, no, 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 there could be medical uses to it. We could do this, we could do that. Yes, I know all that. But just the idea, it doesn't matter what, you cannot look at anything without thinking in what way can I make use of it, is a very crass way to exist. With this level of existence, you will have everything and you will have nothing. This is modern life. People have everything like never before and they got nothing in their lives. Nothing that you can call of any worth. People who have everything and cannot feel life in any significant way, when they die or when the moment of death comes, they will see that they spent this whatever number of years without living a moment. Because what can I get, what can I get is a sure way not to live. Because from what you get, you can only make a living. It's only by what you give that you make a life. So giving does not mean money or something else or something else. It is just that this moment, if you look at this tree, how totally you can give yourself to this tree, that is how intensely you know life. If you sit here and calculate, what can I get out of this tree, you will completely miss life. Completely. Life will evade you. So, this kind of science which denies you life should be restricted if you ask me. I know I'm going to be hugely unpopular because somebody is going to Twitter and say, Sadhguru says science should be curtailed. It's all right. I'm telling you, a science which is driven just by what can I get out of it needs to be controlled a bit. Otherwise, human beings will have everything and they'll have nothing. When that is your experience, then you will destroy everything. Today, the planet is not being destroyed because of something else. It is just unbridled use of technology, isn't it? It could have been used for our well-being, but it's working against us because we have not worked the other dimensions of life. We are just going with this, what can I get, what can I get. If you go with this, there will be no planet left after some time. But even if the planet is left, suppose we rope in another 10 planets, still it will not be enough. We will still have nothing, we'll have everything. This is my experience. Science should have been just a quest to know, not to exploit the creation. It is just a longing to know. Human longing to know wants to find expression in every possible way. Physical sciences is one of the ways, perfectly fine. But once it starts serving the masters who sponsor it, then if businesses sponsor it, they are looking for profit from it. If nations sponsor it, they are looking how to make more powerful weapons out of it all the time. You must understand this. The cutting-edge science always first becomes cutting-edge military technology. Only after that it comes down to other uses. How many lives has it taken? How many more do we want to take? That's a question. So, this goddamn particle, one good thing it's done is, the whole world is thinking particle physics. I like that. That's nice. But do you know the boson is named after Satyendranath Bose? You know this? No? It's an Indian mathematician a self-taught mathematician. As Albert Einstein acknowledged, he said, the Western sciences couldn't take a single step without the Indian mathematicians. The fundamentals of mathematics came from the East. But always here, the other ethos of the culture said, you should not do anything that's exploitative to nature, because nature was seen as Mother Nature. You don't go about raping Mother Nature. You take only what you need, nothing more. Because of that attitude, this science was not converted into technology, and that is the wisest way to handle science. Just as a quest, a tool, a way to know, and nothing beyond that, and technology must be really controlled. What is absolutely needed, that's all that should be done. This unbridled usage, already people are talking how to use the boson that they have not seen. Then we can use the atom that we have not seen. So it doesn't matter what you see, you're thinking of how to use it. This attitude, unfortunately, has been further fueled by the attitude of science. This needs to be checked, otherwise it will be our nemesis. It will for sure be a goddamn everything.